The Inspector window allows us to view and edit the properties and settings of game objects and assets, as well as other preferences and settings in the Unity editor. When we select a game object in the Hierarchy window or Scene view, or an asset in the Project window, the Inspector window will display all of the properties, components, and materials on that game object or asset. Depending upon what we select, the Inspector will display different information. Inspecting a setting, such as the player settings, will look different from inspecting an asset, such as a model or texture. One of the most common items to inspect is a game object, either from our current scene or a game object prefab asset from our project. Game objects are essentially containers for components, which drive the behavior of our game objects. When inspecting a game object, the topmost section displays information about the game object itself. Below that, the inspector displays details about the components attached to the game object. It's worth noting that every game object must have a transform component attached, so every game object, even an empty game object, will display a header and a transform. The first part of the game object's header bar contains the select icon button for the selected game object. The Select Icon button allows us to change the way that a game object is displayed in the scene view. We can also assign a custom icon from any texture in our Assets folder by clicking the Other button and selecting our desired icon. Next to the Game Object's Icon button is a checkbox. This checkbox allows us to toggle whether or not the game object is active in the scene. When a game object is active, all of the enabled components on the game object will be processed while the game is running. When the game object is deactivated, all of the enabled components and custom scripts attached to that game object will be ignored. This includes components which render or display the game object in the scene. So when the game object is inactive, it is turned off or hidden in the scene. It's also worth noting that when a game object is deactivated, its name is also grayed out within the hierarchy window. In many cases, individual components attached to the game object can be toggled on and off by enabling or disabling the component. We will discuss this later in the lesson. The next item in the header bar is the name field for the game object. The name field allows us to easily name and identify the game objects in our scene. The static toggle is used to define whether or not a game object is static and should be considered as a candidate for processes such as light mapping, navigation mesh calculations, occlusion culling, or other specific cases. Static flags can be set individually for specific processes if necessary. For more information on the static flag and which processes use them, please see the information link below. Underneath the name field, the header bar also contains the tag and layer drop-down menus. The tag drop-down menu allows us to assign a tag to the game object. This tag helps us identify a game object or group of game objects for reference in our scripts or to help us when performing a search. The layer drop-down menu allows us to assign our game objects to a specific layer within the editor. Layers are useful as we can assign special rules to specific layers such as lighting, rendering, or collision rules and change the way that any game objects in these layers behave in our scene. It is worth noting that these layers are abstract groups of related game objects, and these layers are not physically arranged in the scene in any way. For more information on tags and layers and how to use them, please see the information linked below. If the game object is a prefab instance, the header bar will display the prefab buttons. The prefab buttons allow us to select and locate our original prefab asset in the project window, revert any changes of the current prefab instance back to the state of the original prefab asset, or apply any changes made to the current instance of the prefab onto our original prefab asset and across any other instances of the prefab asset that are in our project. For more information on prefabs and how to use them, please see the information linked below. Below the header bar are a list of all of the components attached to the game object. we can use the inspector to edit the properties and settings of our GameObject's components. Properties are specific values or references to other objects or assets. Values in the inspector are represented by text boxes, checkboxes, and menus depending on their type. It is worth noting that as well as entering a value into the field, numeric text boxes can be changed by clicking and dragging up or down over the property name. Numeric text boxes can also resolve simple mathematical formula. References are component properties that link to other objects and assets. To assign a reference in the inspector window, we can simply click the small select icon to the right of the property. This will open the object picker. The object picker lets us search for and select game objects and assets within the scene or project that match our selected property type. We can also assign reference properties by dragging an asset or game object from the scene view, hierarchy window, or project window onto the reference property in the inspector window. When dragging a game object, if the selected game object contains a component that matches the reference property type, Unity will assign the appropriate component to the matching reference. If a matching component type cannot be found on the game object, it will be rejected. This makes it very easy to assign references by simply dragging the game object itself into the reference rather than the individual components. The inspector window can also be used to easily find assets and game objects that are being referenced. Clicking on an assigned reference property will reveal the location of the assigned game object or asset in the project or hierarchy window. The inspector window also allows us to change the values of multiple game objects at the same time. When we have two or more game objects selected, most components that our selected game objects have in common can be edited. If the property values of all the selected game objects are the same, the value will be shown in the property field. If the property value is different between the selected game objects, a dash will be displayed instead. If we change the value of any of the shared components in the inspector window, the value will be copied to all of our currently selected game objects. We can easily view the documentation for most components directly from the inspector. Clicking the blue book icon will open the documentation page for that component and allow us to find more information about how to use the selected component. As there are actions that can change the focus of the inspector window, we can lock the inspector window at any time by clicking the small padlock icon in the top right of the inspector window. This will lock the focus on the currently selected item. This can be useful if we wish to keep an inspector window open while we're working on other items. It is also worth noting that we can have more than one inspector window open at one time. To open another inspector window, we can simply click the menu button next to the lock and choose Add Tab, Inspector. This allows us to have one locked instance of the inspector window open and a second instance to show our current selection. When we're finished with our locked instance, we can either close the tab if we're working with multiple inspector windows, or click the lock icon again to unlock the inspector window. The inspector window has two modes available: normal mode and debug mode. In normal mode, the inspector window shows all of the publicly editable properties. If a custom editor for that asset or component is available, the custom editor will be used. In debug mode, the inspector shows only the component's properties. However, this mode shows all of the component's properties, including private ones, making it far easier to debug any unexpected or unwanted behavior. It is also worth noting that although private variables are displayed in debug mode, their values cannot be edited. In many cases, individual components attached to a game object can be toggled on and off by enabling or disabling the component. When a component is disabled, the component will be ignored when the game is running, it is possible to enable or disable many different combinations of components on a game object, allowing us to experiment with how different components work or to explore different behaviors during development. So as we can see, the inspector window is a simple and easy way to view and to interact with and adjust the properties of our game objects and assets.